Dr. Pitts, Reverend Frank Dukes, and myself crafted the idea. We don't call it a boycott, but we're going to call it a selective buying campaign. In other words, it's teaching African Americans to teach their money to have some sense.
At that time, we said we would start a selective buying campaign.
That there are three tiers in the civil rights movement. One was foot soldiers, and the next tier was support group, and the next tier was a legal group who made contribution, that type of thing.
I've always had that thrust of freedom, justice, and equality. And that was the battle cry of the Myers College students when we said, what are you fighting for? Reverend Frank Dukes and all of them would say, freedom, justice, and equality.
Reverend Dukes came in the first tier. He was a diehard and would foot soldier to that day and even to this day.
It was his influence, his thinking, his meeting with Dr. Pitts, who's the president of Myers, who he gave us dynamic leadership.
They sent a message.
The Voting Rights Act came about directly because of what happened in Birmingham. What happened in Birmingham came about as a result of what happened at Myers College. What happened with the selective buying campaign.
And when we got in the full thrust, all the agitation had been done. And then the foot soldiers were forgotten. The movement came in from out of town, but it was through Frank Dukes' leadership that we turned Birmingham upside down.
When Reverend Fred Shuttlesworth visited the SCLC convention, it was the selective buying campaign that he made note of. He said to Dr. King and his colleagues and his allies, come to Birmingham because of what's already occurring with Myers College students and this selective buying campaign.
We had students who were beaten downtown, and we had people who were protesting. You know, back in that time, it was rough.
The black folk had demonstrated that they were ready to protest and do whatever it took to get some freedom, justice, and equality in Birmingham.
How do you convince the people of the power of peace and passivity when they're facing unthinkable cruelty, degradation, and violence? How do you convince the people to let reason and intelligence triumph over violence and ignorance? How do you win a war without ever firing a gun? You think, you strategize, and then you take a stand. You get a forward-thinking college president with a gift for diplomacy and a small eclectic mix of college students and three upper-middle-class housewives who all understand that when it comes to affecting lasting change, nothing speaks to the heart of a persecutor more effectively than economic decimation. And when you do that, you lay the foundation that would prepare a city for the coming of a king. Get ready for Stand, the definitive documentary which chronicles the events that provided the unshakable foundation for the demonstrations in Birmingham, Alabama in 1963. Stand has particular emphasis being placed on the pivotal role played by Myers College students and their supporters, and features Dr. Jonathan McPherson, renowned historian Dr. Horace Huntley, Jeff Drew, Eileen Walbert, Ruth Bearfield Pendleton, Reverend Dr. Willie Clyde Jones, Bishop Calvin Woods, Hezekiah Jackson IV, Mr. Nims Gay, current Myers College President, Dr. George T. French Jr., and many more. Aimed at enlightenment rather than controversy, Stand brings a unique and in some cases unheard voice to the heroes and heroines of a movement which served as a catalyst for tolerance, acceptance, and progress. 11 years in the making and packed with innovative and gripping style, Stand is certain to be one of the must-see documentaries of 2013.
Bull Connor then commanded the police department to come and escort us out of City Hall, and he told me to be out of town by sundown. And I was.
This is not a documentary to incite hatred. This is not a documentary to inflame or to anger. this is a documentary to spotlight truth.
Oh, white folks ain't bad and all blacks ain't good.
The selective buying campaign, I think, is the single most important event which led to the coming of Martin Luther King to Birmingham in the spring of 1963.
This is a documentary to promote tolerance and harmony.
Dr. Pitts was a genius at getting white folk and black folk together.
There is no more important educational institution in the country right now than Miles College.
This is a documentary to pay homage and celebrate men and women, blacks and whites, led by and buoyed by the irrepressible courage of Miles College students who sparked a movement that ultimately changed the world.
After about between 6 and 8 weeks, Parisians desegregated all their water fountains and toilets. And I believe that Lowermans desegregated all their water fountains and toilets.
And the success of that movement was remarkable. When it came time to choose sides, as it were, in the battle for human rights and dignity, I had to take a stand.